Good day, it's John Shumade from Agape Love Potential Ministry. Our weekly broadcast to you today. I believe I meet you well. And I declare no weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. Thank you for all those who have been sharing, liking, making comments. We love you. And we continue to be loved by you and as God loves you all. We declare that no weapon of the enemy fashioned against you shall prosper. Yes, God will do what it says he will do. And it will come true for you. No weapon of the enemy formed against you and I shall prosper. It won't work. No weapon formed against you and I and our families will prosper. It will not work. Because God is at work in us. As we put on the shield of faith, the Lord that we serve will do all he promises to do. And he will work wonder in our life. In the name of Jesus, brethren, we have made the declaration that no weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. Today we are looking at the shield of faith. Ephesians 6:16 says, above all, taking the shield of faith, with which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. Let it be known that whatever happens daily, we must put on faith and put it into practice. Not just head knowledge, but we begin to put it to practice. We begin to declare the word of God. It says in Ephesians 6:16 that no weapon that we should take the shield of faith, which we have to quench the fiery darts of the wicked one. That means no weapon of the enemy will work against us. As long as we put on the shield of faith. We are walking through Ephesians tells us so many things. It tells us that what we are dealing with, they are people who are wicked. Powers, rulers of wickedness. It tells us that, that we are dealing with spiritual hosts of wickedness in heavenly places. So we cannot deal with them with flesh. And so we need to put on the armor, the truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the gospel of peace, which we did last week. I titled that a peace of God. And today we are dealing with a shield of faith. Right, talking about faith is the shield of the believer. Faith is trusting in God's power and protection. That is why we be to declare, no weapon fashioned against me shall prosper. No weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. Why? It's the word of God that says it, and we believe it. So, it gives us that protection. We trust in God's power to protect us as we remain steadfast with his word, faith. When battle rages in our life, we must remember that God is at work in all things. He remains true to his promise. What are his promises to us? Think about it. What are the promises to us? He says, well, one of the things that we want to remember is what? He will never forsake us. He says that he will meet all our needs according to the riches of Christ Jesus. Philippians 4:19. When did that of lack come sin? Let us remember Philippians 4:19. That's a weapon, that a shield of faith that you're going to put on it and you believe it. Yes, it says that whenever we call upon him, he will answer us. So let's take that word to him. You're putting on the shield of faith. Because as you declare the word of God, they begin to bring faith in you and I. It says, they gave strength to the weary. God is our strength. Isaiah 40, verse 31. It says that, but the hope, our hope is in the Lord. If we renew our strength, we will soar like the wing of eagle. We will run and not grow weary. We will walk and not faint. That's the word of God. Do you believe it? If you believe it, put it on the shield of faith and begin to work for you. And he also promised to give us rest. Matthew 11, 28 to 9 to 30. He says, come to me, those who are weary. Are you weary? Come to him. Those who labor, are you laboring in the heavy laden that the enemy has put upon you? Come to me. He said, I will give you rest. It's a promise. Take that promise and go to him. He said, take my yoke upon you and learn from me. I am gentle and lowly in earth, and you will find rest for your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. You will find rest for your soul. If you've been walking in depression, oppressive spirit, restlessness, come to him. Come to him. If you've never known Christ and the devil has been messing with you, come to him. You will find rest. The rest he gives to you, they are kind of rest that no man can give you. And also don't forget Isaiah 54:10. For he loves you and his love never fails. Therefore the mountain will depart. The problem and the issue, the ills will be removed. But my servant Lord shall never depart from you. That is a promise to take to him. Friends, I want you to put on the shield of faith today. And every day as you wake up, put on, read that Ephesians 6 from verse 10 to the end. You begin to see glorious victory upon your life. Believers, I'm going to end the broadcast today. And I pray that the weapon of the enemy fashioned against you shall prosper. And every tongue that rises up against you in judgment, today, collectively, we condemn them. Today, we declare our victory. Today, we declare our victory. We declare our victory. You are already victorious. Revelation 12:11. You have overcome by the blood and the word of your testimony. Bless you. Like, share, set the alarm, and broadcast this to as many people, and you'll be blessed.